Hello and welcome to The Viewpoint. I'm your host Ajay Mathur, presenting yet power-packed version of The Viewpoint podcast. Today, my guest is an eminent top cop of the Indian Police Services. He is a recipient of Maharashtra State Urdu Sahitya Academy Award. He's been groomed in both Indian and international universities for all his training and orientation work. He's presently serving as Commissioner of Police, Mumbai Railways. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in extending a warm welcome to my guest of honor, Sri Kaiser Khalisab. So, welcome to the show, Mr. Khalid.
Thank you, Ajay. It's a pleasure to talk to you.
Sir, it is my honor. So, let us start from the initial phase of your journey, which has been full of struggles, strife, and I believe your early childhood days were absolutely in a very distressed state of affairs, from where you have turned the challenge into an opportunity. Please share your valuable experience till you finally made it to the civil service as a top scorer.
I think life teaches you a lot of lessons, and to exist at some place which is not favorable to you or is not very favorable to you itself creates opportunities for your creating your own identity, and actually I think prompts you to define who you are and define your goals, define your future and what you want to do with your life. So even though very early in my life, I would have been around 5 years old when I was sent to my maternal uncle's place, my Nanihal, for studies. Actually, I started my schooling at my Nani's place. So right. He's a very, very child of 5 years old, and then he is being sent all the way away from his parents to a place for education. This experience many of us have when we are sent or packed to different boarding schools. But then a boarding school is a much better place to live in, because then you are well taken care of. A village milieu is a very different location and situation. But nevertheless, it taught me a lot of things. It taught me resilience. It taught me tenacity. It taught me that only hard work will lead me to define myself. And the faith and conviction that I can make my own destiny and I can find my own identity. Even though, you know, it was a difficult situation to live without your parents, to live in a situation where you are one among many people, and village schools, unlike the schools which we have now, are the schools where actually you just go to school, the teachers teach you, and you learn something, come back, and then again and again, cycle is repeated till you're out of the school. So the quality education, as we understand now, is not a great emphasis here, because it is a general kind of education where everybody learns to read and write and probably speak. Mm-hmm. But I think living in a village, getting exposed to different cultures, the composite nature of our society, because an agrarian society is a very composite society. You have farmer and you have a lot of people who support that farming activity. There will be people who will be making the things out of wood, out of metal, people catching fish, people who are into dairy, people who are growing vegetables and selling into the market, people who are just working class people. And it's a kind of mix. Villages have a very cordial relation. They are, in a way, they may profess different religions and they have different places of worship, but they exist in a kind of harmony. So we celebrated Holi, we celebrated Durga Utsav, what we call as Navaratri, or Vijayadashmi. We celebrated Eid, Bakrid, and all other things. So in a way, it taught me a lot of things about India. Mm-hmm. So village, close to nature, communal harmony, social harmony, and learning that we progress together as a society in integration, in collaboration, actually provided me the roots of my conviction and actually introduced me to this country in a way which other things would not have introduced me. It created that image of an India which is a harmonious India, an India where humanity and humanism is very important, an India where we actually celebrate each other's festival, an India where religion is just a personal practice, and an India where we share common vision and common goal of moving ahead in life. So I think that adversity itself created a lot of opportunities for me.
So I was pursuing your program, and I found that while you were preparing for your civils, a time came when one of your mentor suggested you to take sannyas. What exactly was it, sannyas?
Well, sannyas is is a situation where your focus is on your goal and only on the goal. It's like what you see, that is a very famous story that we read early in our childhood, that when Arjuna went in the swayamvar of Draupadi with his guru, and there was a fish there.
Mm-hmm.
And the guru asked that, "Arjun, can you see the fish?" He said, "No, sir, I can't see the fish." The guru was very, very kind of upset and was in fact came into stress. He said, "Then what are you seeing?" He said, "I'm seeing the eye of the fish, which is my goal." So in a way, sannyas is just to focus on your goal and cut off from the rest of the things, keep other relations and other things at a distance for some time, and give your complete focus, complete energy, complete, I should say, effort to that one goal, which is your career. So sannyas, in a way, taught us to prioritize our things, to be totally dedicated and devoted to our goal, and also that together we've been, actually. I was in a place called Hamdard Study Circle in Delhi. And there were a lot of around 50, 60 odd students there. So we all were in kind of an ashram, where we all were preparing for our career objectives, career goals. And everybody was completely focused on that goal. Of course, not everybody qualified. There were a lot of people who could not qualify. But this taught us a lot of things. And those who could not qualify, they have done well in life in other spheres or fields. So sannyas is kind of focused on your goal and a kind of disconnect with the rest of the things, because other desires and other attractions, if they keep pulling you down, you will not be able to focus on your goal and you will not be able to achieve your reach to your destination.
So what was your first take when you got the coveted Lal Batti? Because I remember that in 1997 that Lal Batti culture was alive and thriving, and you must have got the, what you call the, literally the pep up in your life. How was that kind of experience when you literally entered the Hall of Fame as the Indian Police Service officer?
I'll tell you what I did when I got this information that I had been selected. I prostrated, did a sajda kind of thing, and thank God that I was nothing. It is only His grace that has been taken me to the destination. Of course, my efforts were important, but my humility and my belief that I can succeed with the grace of God was always unshaken. Even today, when I get something, I always refer it back. It's my creator who has granted me this thing. This keeps me humble, this keeps me grounded, and this keeps me connected to the common people of this country. I go to slums, I go to the areas where poor kids live, and I normally do a lot of counseling and career guidance here. I move many a time on foot. People will not recognize me, but I go and sit on the bus stand, I see what they are doing. I go to some place to find out what is going on there. and completely incognito. Vehicle, lal batti, uniform, other things are just a means to keep a good, that is serving people, in service of the people. But I think a man or a human being should never change. He should never forget his roots and should never forget the huge responsibilities which the government has bestowed on his shoulders and the faith that government of India has put in you and your conviction that law is supreme. We are all servants of law and we are here to serve our people, our master, which is the common man of this country. So I think that these things actually don't affect, and I feel very strongly that it should not affect anybody. It should only prompt us to serve people better and understand this is an opportunity. This will not be always there. This opportunity will go away from me after some period of time. So even if I serve people, or even if I don't serve people, this time will come when I'll superannuate. So why not to retire or superannuate as a contented person, as a person who, when you look back, who will remember that, yes, I tried my best to bring happiness in the life of people. I tried to minimize and reduce their pain and suffering. I tried to get them justice. I tried to guide them on the path of claiming their rights and all those things. So I think this vehicle or this uniform or this whatever jalwa and all whatever people say is essentially a means to an end, and that end is serving the people of our country.
So you have been instrumental in not only curbing law, not only curbing the crime rate, which has been on the escalation ladder within the country at various positions that you've held, but you have been you played a pivotal role in making history in many sense, though your subject was geography, if my research is correct. What were the major challenges? I mean, today, to come to think of it, we are standing on the brink of, God forbid, Third World War, and Indian government is pursuing to bring the Indian students stranded in those places back to Mumbai. How big is this challenge for you in making them go back to their homes safely and soundly, even if they are living in remote villages of the rural in India?
I think every crisis is a human tragedy. It brings a lot of human tragedy in its path, in its course, and the victim is probably the people who are most defenseless. In this case, like our students who were born here for a better future, and the kind of situation they find themselves in, probably they would have never imagined this even in their worst dreams. So it is a humanitarian crisis. And my prayers are with those people who are stuck up there. I will not comment on what's going on because it is for everybody to see. But I do feel that people who are not a party to the conflict must be given a safe passage, must be allowed to return back to their places of choice. And we must save as much on as many human lives as possible, and especially those who are innocent, especially those who are non-combatant. I think they have a right and a fundamental right to be protected, not to be attacked, and to be allowed to leave because they have no role in that conflict.
So if you permit, and if I may sneak into your another very passionate fervor that you nurture, is your love and passion for the great, beautiful language called Urdu, for which you've not only done two magnificent anthologies, but also have contributed magnanimously in bringing Urdu at the forefront of the entire rural and urban India. How did this passion got ignited in you, Mr. Khalid?
This passion actually comes from the fact that I love languages. And I think all Indian languages have this potential to grow and prosper and actually match any other language. be it English or be it French, in terms of its quality, in terms of its literature, and in terms of its history. I'm a native Urdu speaker. In fact, my early education was in Urdu language. Therefore, I read a lot of literature of Urdu, and I fell in love with the poetry of this language. You understand, you would in fact recall that Urdu has got a unique genre, which is called Ghazal.
Absolutely. So, and you have done beautiful work. I've in fact gone through your works. Your passion for Ghazals is immaculate.
So that is something which helps you express yourself.
सर कुछ हो जाए, मौका भी है, दस्तूर भी है, फागुन का महीना भी है, इस जश्ने बहारा में आप इतने, आपने एक बहुत, आपने दो दो जो माशाल्लाह जो एनजीओज भी खोले हैं और जो आपने किताबें भी लिखी हैं, वो भी इसी पर्टिकुलर यू नो फर्वर को फॉस्टर करती हैं सर. सो आई With all humility at my command, I will request, because it's a very strange combo. You are a top cop and you're a poet. So I will request with all humility to share some of your nazams that you have put in the wonderful collection of books that you've written.
I'll recite some of the couplets from my latest ghazal.
Irshad.
Irshad,
sir.
You to hamare beech कोई फासला न था, यूं तो हमारे बीच कोई फासला न था, लेकिन वो खुल के भी तो किसी दिन मिला न था, लेकिन वो खुल के भी तो किसी दिन मिला न था, यूं तो हमारे बीच कोई फासला न था,
बहुत खूब,
लेकिन वो खुल के भी तो किसी दिन मिला न था,
क्या
उसकी तरफ से जब मिला इसमें कबूलियत, When the beloved gave me hint, yes, I shall be accepted. Uski taraf se jab mila isne qabooliyat, tayyar uthne ke liye dast-e dua na tha. My hands were unwilling to rise in prayer and supplication. I mean, that was my situation.
Beautiful.
So, it's a letter, but I'll recite some of the things which is more easy. So one of my couplets, which is popular, goes like this: ke chup ke seene mein ek aankh si to rahe, chup ke seene mein ek aankh si to rahe, shahr-e-jaan mein kahin roshni to rahe, aur ye hai daur-e-hawas, lekin aisa bhi kya? Agreed that this is an age of desires and greed. Ye hai daur-e-hawas, lekin aisa bhi kya? आदमी कम से कम आदमी तो रहे.
आहा, what a beautiful note on humanity, sir. What a beautiful note. मैं सजदा करता हूँ सर आपके इस पर्टिकुलर यू नो थॉट प्रोसेस का. इट्स ब्यूटिफुल एंड अनराइवल्ड. प्लीज गो अहेड सर. हम तो सर मुरीद हो गए आपकी इन शेरों का, इन शेर शायरी का, क्योंकि मैं खुद यू नो इस पर्टिकुलर लैंग्वेज से इश्क फरमाता हूँ.
लैंग्वेज इज वन विच गिव्स यू कैथारसिस. एक्चुअली इफ यू आर अनहैप्पी, इफ यू आर सैड, इफ यू आर इन ट्रबल, इफ यू रीड और लिसन टू पोएट्री, इट हैज अ सूथिंग इम्पैक्ट. It will soothe you. So that is something. Actually, when I don't feel very great, I would read or I'll recite or I'll listen to a good poetry. And because poetry is essentially, ये कहिए कि जो आप बीती है उसको जग बीती बना देता है. That means whatever you feel, you will realize that a lot of people share the same sentiment.
So, but I have seen you. I've seen you as an motivational speaker, but I've seen that there's a golden heart that you have for people who are deprived, who are destitute, but still you are, if you permit, sir, and you don't hang me up, you are a romantic person. A poet is always brimming with romance. कहाँ से लाते हैं इतनी मोहब्बत?
ये मोहब्बत आई टोल्ड यू ना कि व्हाट हैपेंड कि आई हैव ग्रोन अप इन अ विलेज सेटिंग. तो गांव में क्या होता है ना कि गांव आपको प्यार करना सिखा देता है. वन यू लव द नेचर, देयर वर रिवर्स, देयर वर ग्रीन फील्ड्स, देयर वर एग्रीकल्चर क्रॉप्स, देयर वर फॉरेस्ट, ट्रीज, बर्ड्स, वाइल्ड फ्लावर्स, एवरीथिंग, फिश, so many things, and you love that thing. So you are in sync with nature if you are a sensitive person. एक दूसरी बात जैसे मैंने बताई कि क्या होता है कि गांव में the harmony is very high. I mean anybody can go to anybody's place and he or she will be treated well. लोग पानी पिला देंगे, कभी चाय भी पिला देंगे, जो खा रहे हैं बिठा लेंगे आपको, आ जाओ भाई खा जाओ, मोहब्बत से बात करते हैं. फिर हमारे तरफ तो सर्दी भी पड़ती थी बिहार में, तो वो यू नो कोयला जला हुआ या आग लगी जला के रखा है, लोग ताप रहे हैं, आप गए आप बैठ गए, लोग एक दूसरे में इंक्लूड कर लेते थे एक दूसरे को. सो इट टीचेस यू लव, इट टीचेस यू रिस्पेक्ट, इट टीचेस यू वैल्यू ऑफ रिलेशनशिप, इट टीचेस यू के सोसाइटी में आपकी पोजिशन इकोनॉमिकली जो भी हो, लेकिन जो आपसे उम्र में बड़ा है वो बड़ा है, आपको उसकी इज्जत करनी है. इस टीचर्स यू की सबको आप काका चाचा मामा फूफा मतलब वट एवर डिपेंडिंग अपन थिंग उस हिसाब से बुलाते हैं. आप किसी को नाम फर्स्ट नाम से नहीं बुलाते हैं और आप सबको सलाम करते हैं, नमस्ते करते हैं और अदब से पेश आते हैं. नहीं तो सबसे पहला प्रॉब्लम क्या होगा, लोग पूछे किसके बेटे हो, किसके बच्चे हो, तो आपका तो नाम गया ही गया, आपके वालदेन का, आपके खानदान का भी नाम गया. तो सेकेंड वॉज दैट. थर्ड इज ऑफकोर्स वेन यू एक्चुअली विजुअलाइज द थिंग्स, नेचर इज सो ब्यूटिफुल. आप उसको देखें और घंटों आप उसको देखें और तकें और सोचें, और जैसे गालिब ने कहा था ना कि दिल ढूंढता है फिर वही फुर्सत के रात दिन बैठे रहें तसव्वुरे जाना किए हुए. अगर आपके पास फुर्सत हो जाए और आप नेचर के पास हों और सब चीज देखते रहें और ढूंढते रहें, तो आपको यू विल बिकम ए रोमांटिक पर्सन. एंड रोमांस डज नॉट नेसेसरीली mean romancing a girl or a boy. It means being in love with your existence. Actually, being in love with where? I'm in love with this country. I'm in love with this city. I mean, I have gone to many other places, many foreign countries, but I always kind of felt ki bhaiya wapas jana hai.
So you have been trained and groomed in France, in Australia, in London University, in so many international places. Apne vatan ki khushboo aur mitti se lagav आज भी आपको उतना ही है जितना उस समय रहा होगा.
अपने चाहिए अपने को. इट इज एज सिंपल एज दैट. अपने जैसे लोग, अपनी मिट्टी की खुशबू चाहिए, अपना खाना चाहिए, अपनी भाषा बोलने वाले लोग चाहिए. यू नो एट सम आफ्टर सम डेज और मे बी अ फ्यू वीक्स यू स्टार्ट मिसिंग ऑन दीज थिंग्स, मिसिंग आउट. एंड अभी मेरा भाई जो है वो इज फिलाडेल्फिया, इज अ प्रेसिडेंशियल स्कॉलर इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ पेंसिल्वेनिया. Doing his research. So, अभी वो बिरयानी बना रहा है. तो ही इज आस्किंग इस
बात. क्या बात है, खुशबू से खुशबू यहाँ तक आ रही है सारा उस बिरयानी की, क्योंकि उसकी महक, उसकी उसके तस्वीर में कुछ बात ही अलग है. So you have been coveted with several awards. How did this Maharashtra State Urdu Sahitya Academy Award came up your way, and how it all happened, sir? Could you share your valuable experience and your journey towards that, sir?
Actually, when you publish a book and submit it for review to the Sahitya Academy, then they get it reviewed by 5 independent learned people, professors and others, and they recommend that whether this book is has any worth or not. So I was awarded that award and with a special mention. So it was on my first anthology actually, and I think when you come in front of people and when you publish something, unless you are able to establish your identity through that book, I think we need to work more. So I was able to establish an identity. It had different themes, it had different kind of language, it had different kind of expression of those themes, and as a poet, I think. And I mentally challenge whatever I see and try to go at the root cause of the thing. Why it is happening this way? Why it is existing this way? Why it is this? Why not something else? You know, this curiosity to learn, this curiosity to explore, this curiosity to discover new things.
actually one make keeps you as a student throughout your life, and secondly, it teaches you a lot of new things, new nuances. And after a lot of effort, then you develop or get an insight into an human into human beings' behavior or thought. That insight is what gives rise to a shape. Without insight, poetry is worthless, because then people will not remember and people will not actually find anything interesting in that.
Correct.
So that insight is very important.
Mm-hmm. Sir, I've also realized that while you were doing your research and your books, you have dwelt into other areas as well, which is again a strange combination. You've handled anti-insurgency operations. You've been doing serving the humanity with Plasma Connect, which has been in the COVID scenario. You have come up with two NGOs, Harmony of Literature and Culture. How did this all evolve in at the same time when you were handling such a very sensitive positions, in the state government, serving the government? How it all happened, sir? I mean, how can you manage it all this?
It all depends on your attitude in life. What you want to make out of your life? You see, when people are in distress, then I ask just one question to myself. What is the best that I can do right now? See, your job demands certain hours of work. The government expects you to be working for 8-9 hours in a day. Beyond that, then you are what under what? 24 minus 9, so you have about 15 hours. You sleep for 7 hours or 6 hours, whatever. Then still you have a lot of time. And if you want to utilize that time productively, I think there are a lot of opportunities available. I've got a different philosophy. My philosophy is that I should leave the place a better place than what I inherited, what I got. What I got is not important. What I leave behind is important. And when I leave behind a place, I should feel contented. And how? Because I should have this feeling in my heart that I tried my best to improve the situation, to serve people, to make a place a better place, to improve procedures and the way people work there, to improve the behavior and relationship issues that we have had. Therefore, I always think that a person's stature should always be judged by what he leaves behind rather than what he got. Now, if you work on this philosophy, then obviously it will keep you, grounded, and it will not keep you, let you live in rest. I mean, you will always be thinking, "Maine kya karna chahiye?" Abhi itne saare log, for example, this COVID crisis, people are dying because there is no plasma available. People are dying because there are no oxygen cylinders available. What do I do? If I can do that thing, people are facing a lot of distress because there is no food available. So can I do this?
Yes, so have spread it. You have distributed 80,000 packets per day to people. You have made them, the migrant laborers, move with ease. I mean, Mumbai is indebted to you for all that you have contributed towards the civil society. Hats off to you, sir.
Thank you. Nobody should feel that indebtedness or something. It is there. It was my responsibility. It was what I could do, what I could contribute at that point of time, and I try to do it. That is all. The rest is, see, as a human being, where do I stand in an hour of crisis? I must stand with the people who are in distress. I must try to help them. And that is what I've been doing. That is what I'm trying to do all the time. That is, in the society, everybody is not as fortunate as we are. God was kind. I got an opportunity. I got into Indian police service. But there are numerous people who have not got that opportunity. And many of them are more talented than me. If they are in distress, if they cannot help themselves, should we not, as human beings, as member of society, help them?
And come on, sir, you've been very, very modest. You've been extremely humble and very modest and grounded. I must salute you for your magnanimity when it comes to humility. Absolutely astounding, sir. And I'm saying from the core of your heart, core of my heart.
Thank you. But I'll tell you, Ajay, I always say this life is nashwar. It has to end one day. and when it will end, at that point of time, you shouldn't have regrets. Whatever you have earned here will be left behind. Nothing will go with you. But I think a good deed may or will go with you. At that point of time, you should not think that I traded badly. And there were a lot of good things which I could have done, but I did not. Rather than I went after something which my greed prompted or what, I don't know, what my desires prompted me. What to do? I mean, after death is inevitable. Everybody will face it one day. And everybody will retire from service. 60 years is the maximum age. What when you reach at that destination, 60 years, you look back. Everybody looks back. And do you think that you will be happy if you think that, oh God, I spent the whole time only for myself? I think I'll not be happy.
So I've seen that you have, you know, you go deep, you take a profound, dip into the ocean of knowledge and learning, especially when it comes to Urdu literature, Urdu, you know, poetry. ये मोती कहाँ से लेके आते हैं सर आप जो आप पिरोते हैं अपनी शेर व शायरी में अपनी जुबान में हमारे बुजुर्ग ने ये कहा करते थे कि बा अदब बा नसीब बे अदब बद नसीब लेकिन आपकी जो शायरी है आपका जो इखलाक है वो कहीं ना कहीं कमिश्नर ऑफ पुलिस आई मीन दिस इज सच अ स्ट्रॉन्गेस्ट पोजिशन दैट इज वन कैन होल्ड एंड स्टिल यू आर सो हम्बल एंड ग्राउंडेड What a
I think
great match.
My family gave this thing to me, and partly my own experiences. But I feel that if you live in the midst of people, common people, general people, speak to them without any kind of arrogance, and learn from them, hear their experiences, hear their sorrow, hear about their losses, hear about their pain and longing, hear about what good things they have achieved in life, happiness and pain, sorrow, longing, love, desires, passion, betrayal, and so many things. The thing which we often don't see in a bureaucratic career, then you will know where the society is going, what is happening in the society, and you'll get a lot of idea and insight about human behavior. And then you will get something which is an idea, which is a thought, which will come to your mind, and you will be able to write something. So I feel that being grounded, being in the midst of people, never forgetting from where I've come and where I'll go back to, and existing as people's man, I think is something which helps me to learn and understand so many things, and that also helps me in generating ideas for my poetry. And also, I've always thought that I must remain a student throughout my life, keep learning, keep improving myself, keep improving my knowledge base, improving my good areas and minimizing my weak areas, which is called introspection. That's what I'm doing and that's what I do. And that is what has helped me in civil services also.
Do you really have weak areas? Do you really have weak areas, Mr. Khalid?
Because
as a motivational speaker... You know, in all your speaking engagements, you have talked about that how one should keep one's head to the ground. But what has been your moment of what you say defiance or moment of losing faith in yourself? Have you ever faced this kind of a blackout in your life, Mr. Khalid?
See, we are challenged every day in and day out. But you will be challenged only when you keep your mind open and free from biases. People challenge, my colleagues challenge, officers working with me, men working with me. They come with ideas which may not be in consonance with what I think. My kids challenge me, my beautiful wife. She would criticize me and I listen to this. And try to learn and try to realize where I make a mistake. Because we are human beings. We are bound to make mistakes. We are bound to have weak areas. But as a good human being, we should always try to learn and try to reduce that thing, try to minimize that area. And so I think my kids have taught me how to be a better father And I had to revise my whole way of how do you approach your kids. I have been brought out in a very different kind of traditional family. There, the way of dealing with or associating with kids was very different. It was more an hierarchical society. But now the society is no longer hierarchical, or the family is no longer hierarchical. It has become very much flat. When it is a flat relationship, then you have to listen to everybody as equal and listen to their criticism, listen to their difference of opinion. And there are occasions when we agree to disagree. So I think that has taught me a lot of lessons in how to be a better human being, how to be a better father, or how to be a better person. And even today, if my kids or my wife thinks there's some area where I need to improve, they will tell me, look into my eyes, straight face, look here, I think you need to reconsider and you need to rethink. And this is probably a better alternative. And you see, you feel challenged, but that is what makes you a better human being. You listen to that carefully. Look what is what they are telling. Look what they are pointing out. Analyze it. And if you find, yes, it is really something which we need to adopt. And I think then only if we grow as human beings. So
but I know you have been as a poet. You have also taken. You've gone out of the. I mean, taken out of the box actions for working. In controlling the in launching the anti-drugs campaign and made a sizable difference in the lives of those who were drug addicts. How, as a poet, you have taken up this challenge?
See, this is something which is probably the weakest link in human relation or behavior. It is pathetic, pathetic. If you sit with a drug addict and speak to him or her, and how they got into this addiction, what were the dreams that got shattered, what were the relationships that became dysfunctional, what was the company which prompted them to experiment and fall into this kind of thing. It is something, is a different world altogether. And pathos that you feel, and the struggle that you see, and how you realize that people are innately not bad. Inherently, they are not bad people. Inherently, they are good people. They try to come out of that. Many times they realize, but there is something called helplessness, and especially the learned helplessness, is something which is very, very dangerous. And also, how important is the support of the family and the society and the friends in keeping somebody stable and keeping him off this kind of hook. So,
If I may be asked to put it in Shairana Andaz from you, sir, how will you put this? Because this is a very people who are, drug addicts don't get into it, this muddle, just like this. So, aap apni ghazal ya apne kisi nazam se us is daure ittefaq ko arz karna chahenge, to main aapse iske liye iltaza karunga.
Dekhiye, ye kya hai ki ye ek aisa issue hai ki bas aap ye samajh lijiye ki rehta nahi hai dil pe hame ikhtiyar bhi. Rehta nahi hai dil pe hame ikhtiyar bhi. उससे शिकायतें भी हैं, उससे ही प्यार भी.
तो आपने रूह को सुकून पहुंचा दिया साहब, कहते हैं आपकी इसी जुबान ने इसी. सो यू ऑल्सो रन टू एनजीओज एंड दे आर प्रमोटिंग हार्मनी इन सोसाइटी. व्हाट हैज बीन द मिशन एंड विजन ऑफ दीज टू एनजीओ दैट यू आर करंटली ऑपरेटिंग?
Essentially, these two NGOs were created for harmony through culture and literature. See, in society, what we realize that people do not associate with police department in such numbers and at such level which we desire to have. In the sense that the people who are professional, the people who are in good positions in life, they will probably never come to a police station and listen to the officer there. If I were to involve these fellows in something which is productive to the society and to create an environment of harmony and better understanding, that is possible only when I give something which is valuable to them, which is close to their heart. So literature is something through which you have this cathartic experiences. And literature is actually kind of it's a lovely field, actually. Everybody passes through a lot of emotions in life. Love is one emotion. Hatred is another emotion. Betrayal is another emotion. Breaking of heart is another emotion. Dysfunctional relationships are under emotion. Loss of a near and dear one is under emotion. Death is under emotion. Birth is under emotion. Your relationship with your colleagues, with your family, with nature, with society, and with people around the world are the relationships which have different dimensions. So good people, or I would say those who have achieved something in life and achieved something big in life, they will be associated only when you have something where they think that time is valuable and which probably gives them a cathartic experience. So it is possible only through literature. And when literature and culture, and when you use culture as a tool, you can convey your message in a much more effective manner than, say, teaching somebody or delivering a speech or lecture. There you've got a targeted audience. But CEOs of the company, intellectuals, members who are working in society and who have reached to a certain position in life, they would generally not come together in such a large number unless it is an event where there is some culture, where there is some music, where there is some singing, where there is some poetry recitation, where there is something where they value. And you see, most of the people, say, who have risen high in life, you ask them, they keep reading. They keep acquiring knowledge. So these people feel very close to culture. And these people come, and these are the people who, if they think, they are influencers, they are opinion makers. If they speak something about this thing, this will actually be a message. So we are getting best of the literatures, writers, poets, artists, and we are getting the cream of the society also, the people who make the opinion in the society, who influence public opinion. When such things happen, then you realize actually that this harmony thing has a chance. It will exist. It will get promoted. It will get propagated. And literature also removes a lot of misgivings and biases that we have been brought up with. Misgiving about a certain community, about a certain religion, about a certain caste, about certain people, certain region, all those things. We have a lot of biases actually. And these biases will be eradicated only when people actually have first-hand experience of such people. So I think it helps in sending that message across. And then we also get a lot of youth into these things. And youth are actually the ambassadors of our culture. They will be the who will be having the key position in society in the coming days. So what will happen that they must be associated with our culture. They must identify and know what our culture is, what are the good things in our culture, what is the beauty of our culture. But a lot of youth is actually getting influenced by a lot of things which are happening outside. So I am totally for understanding and learning about other cultures, other languages also. But my own foundation must be very strong. And that is possible only when you bring culture before them in a way in which they appreciate it, the way they like it. No lecture will serve that purpose. But if an event has musical, if an event has singing, if an event has got a Kavi Sammelan or a Mushaira or that kind of thing, if you can have food, if you can have painting exhibition, you can have certain classical dances, then it will attract people. So that is what we are trying to do.
I'm getting an online question from my listener based out of Navi Mumbai. He is asking that is Khalid Saab going to write for the Bollywood blockbusters one day?
Who knows?
Because I believe that the conviction of Diwar is still resonating somewhere deep down in your gray matter.
See, who knows? These are challenges and opportunities. So maybe one day might come. When I superannuate and I have a lot of time, and then some opportunity comes, why not?
What really is the most favorite or the most fanciful thing that you will appreciate in your life the passion for poetry. Your commitment to serve the nation is one of the most honest, sincere, full of integrity, IPS officer, or somebody who understands human as humane. What exactly does really touch your heart?
The thing that I would value the most is actually those who guided me, the love and the compassion of the people who guided me, who taught me, who held my hand, and who always encouraged me that I can achieve this goal, who prayed for me, and the grace of the Almighty. I think that is what is most valuable. Rest is actually an outcome of that. So I will always think that I'm grateful to so many people whom I do not know, but who pray for me. And love that I've got from people, and the respect that I've got from people, and the way they have encouraged me, the way they have kept my morale high during hours of crisis. I think that is the most valuable thing that I have.
Sir, Awaaz Di Voice fosters inclusiveness in weaving a social ethos for the nation, so that we are able to build up a progressive India of our dreams. What is Bharat of your dreams? Especially as we celebrate Amrit Mahotsav.
At Amrit Mahotsav, when we have turned 25, I think India is all about inclusivity, inclusion. Mm-hmm. India is a country which has welcomed everybody who has come here with an open arm. We have learned from others. We have taught others. And that is how we have grown, and that is how we have become more powerful, a better nation. So India is all about inclusion. India is all about love. India is all about compassion. India is all about learning. And India is all about art and culture. And India is all about humanism. I think that is what my India is.
What are the futuristic projects that you have in hand besides looking after the ailing society and serving them with your best of integrity?
As of now, since I'm coming working as Commissioner of Police Railways, so we have around 3,500 accidental deaths on track. People who are crossing the track and are hit by train. These are 3,500 able-bodied working persons who need death, and which we can minimize, reduce, or even eliminate. That is something on which I am working. We have just launched a software and gathering data where this is happening, why this is happening, and how to prevent it, how to minimize it. Because in a city like Mumbai, you have around 200-250 murders in a year, and you have 3,500 of the people who are neither criminal and whose offense is, or whose only mistake is this, that they are crossing the railway line or railway track. So the readiness of the family, and if we could minimize it or reduce it even by 50%, that means actually we are saving, say, 1,700-1,800 people's life, and that is something which is very high on my priority, and that is what I am working on right now.
So what is your favorite food that you would love to eat, and how do you spend your time and leisure, if you may share some of those lovely golden moments that you spend with your family?
Well, my favorite food is salad with any non-vegetarian dish, good non-vegetarian dish, maybe kebab or something. That I would love to have.
And then kebab ke saath kuch, you know, sher o shayari bhi ho jaye to wo mashallah lajawab ho jati hai. To main फिर से, बिकॉज पोएट इज अ पोएट इज अ पोएट. तो सर आपकी उर्दू शायरी के तो हम सच्चे में खुशाम, मतलब कोई शब्द ही नहीं है हमारे पास में. तो कबाब की जब बात हो तो आप कुछ अर्ज करें इशारत.
तो नाजुक है ये रास्ता, इस पे न चल. नाजुक है ये रास्ता, इस पे न चल. ऐ इश्क संभल, ऐ शौक बदल.
आहा, ए, 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 ए. इश्क बदल
संभल
इस संभल
शौक बदल नाजुक ये रास्ता इस पे ना चल
सर ये बारीकियां ये नजाकत यूनिफॉर्म में आप कहां से लाते हैं सॉरी फॉर बीइंग सो फ्रैंक एंड स्ट्रेट जैकेटेड बट कहां से लाते हैं सर ये आप
यूनिफॉर्म के अंदर इंसान तो वही रहता है ना इंसान नहीं बदलता है कोई भी मैंने ये महसूस किया है कि आदमी कितना ही ऊंचा पोजीशन पे पहुंच जाए लेकिन उसके अंदर का इंसान जो है ना वो नहीं बदलता है वो वही रहता है सो वी ऑल्सो फील वी ऑल्सो इमोट वी ऑल्सो एक्सप्रेस हाँ ठीक है थोड़ा रिस्ट्रेन हो जाता है लेकिन वी आर एसेंशियली ह्यूमन बींग्स एंड एज ह्यूमन बींग्स वो सारे जो क्वालिटीज एक इंसान में होती है वो हमें भी है एंड मैंने इसको कोशिश किया है डेवलप करने का बहुत लोग नहीं करते हैं बट आई ट्राई टू डेवलप दिस सो दैट के you know it is basically a great stress buster if you could get something which is productive if you get something which is cathartic so I think that is one thing that is there and most of the time when I'm with my family I'll speak with them I'll listen to them and I got two daughters and they are doing well in their studies so they will tell about themselves what they have done for the day what is this what they have written and all those things so that is one thing that I do And we also discuss a lot of things about our anything under the sun, actually, because my wife is a doctorate in English literature, and
I'm abreast about the romantic interlude that you had with her prior to your wedding, and probably somehow or the other that still resides in deep in your heart. Am I right in my perception, sir?
Yes, in a way, we are both literature person and also a lot of then I love, hosting people. People come to our house and they think that we prepare good food. So that is one part. Then among the friends we'll sit and sometimes I'll go on a walk and, you know, it's kind of when you connect with nature.
So who are your favorites? Because you know when you write ghazals, to mashallah aap gungunate bhi honge apne waqt mein jab jo aapko wo haseen pal hote honge to kya hum guzarish kar sakte hain khalid sahab se ki wo aaj apni ek nazm gungunake ke sunaye apni rasili awaaz mein jisme chashni mili hui hai
main khuda har aadmi bharti आता नहीं करता है तो सुर और ये जो चीजें हैं जरा मुश्किल से मुझे आती है मतलब मैं इसीलिए नज़मे में जो पढ़ता हूँ या गज़लें पढ़ता हूँ तहत में पढ़ता हूँ तो वो गुनगुना जरा मुश्किल है मेरी वाइफ अच्छा गाती हैं तो कभी अगर मौका मिलेगा तो मैं उनसे कुछ सुनवा दूंगा लेकिन बुनियादी तौर से मैं प्रोज पढ़ने वाला आदमी हूँ तो पोइट्री में ये कहिए कि जो फीलिंग्स का जब जोर इतना ज्यादा हो जाता है कि आप चीजों को मिनिमम वर्ड्स में कन्वे करना चाहते हैं तो उस हवाले से मैं इन चीजों को लिखने लगा बुनियादी तौर मेरा पिछला जो सवाल था इसी हम लोग बैठते हैं बातें करते हैं या कुछ देखते हैं कभी मूवी देख ली पिक्चर कहीं चले गए तो इट इज लाइक दिस वी आर जस्ट नॉर्मल पीपल नथिंग एक्सेप्शनल बट हाँ हमें नई चीजें देखने नई चीजों को करने या नॉलेज हासिल करने में वो जरा अच्छा लगता है
सर इंडिया इज फेसिंग द होल वर्ल्ड इन द पोस्ट पेंडेमिक यू नो वे हैज चेंज्ड कंप्लीटली देयर इज अ प्रोपेगेंडा वॉरफेयर गोइंग अक्रॉस एट वेरियस लेयर्स ऑफ सोसाइटी हाउ डू यू फोरसी दिस पर्टिकुलर ट्रेंड इज इट समथिंग दैट we need to put a tap of how the freedom of expression and the kind of thing how do you see that sir
they're fizzling out democracy is what we have chosen for ourselves which includes a guarantee of fundamental rights as given in our constitution
correct
and I think that is something constitution is something which we must defend at all costs And I think as a concerned citizen and citizen of this country, I take pride that our constitution is one which has actually given this in writing. So something, I think this society has always been a society which has believed in democracy and which has always respected divergence of opinion. And that is how we have evolved as a nation and as a society. And I think this is one of the most beautiful things that has ever happened to this country. So we must preserve that thing.
As we come to the last segment of the podcast, I would urge upon you to, you know, share some of your nazams as we celebrate not only the Amrit Mahotsav, but the 75 years beyond, as we will touch 150 years for independence. How do you see India, that is liberal, progressive, and has a mindset of its own for the future perfect planet?
See, the any society will have a lot of convergences and a lot of divergences. So, हर सोसाइटी में थोड़ा सा केओस रहना या लॉ को ऑब्वे करना, ये चीजें रही हैं, रहती हैं, क्योंकि इंसान का जो नेचर है वो पिछले 4-5 हजार साल में तो नहीं बदला है. तो ये जो ऐसा ही रहेगा. बट व्हाट इज इम्पोर्टेंट, इसकी प्रीडोमिनेंट मेजोरिटी ऑफ द कंट्री शुड बी लॉ अबाइडिंग. एंड व्हेन आई स्पीक ऑफ लॉ, आई मीन एवरी लॉ, इंक्लूडिंग ट्रैफिक लॉ, वन. एंड सेकंड एंड वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इज की we are the people who speak a lot about humanism, humanity and everything, but we must express that thing in our practical life. For example, if somebody has met with an accident, my first and foremost responsibility is to provide any kind of help that I can do to him or her and not to run away. So we should not be hypocrites. I find a lot of hypocrisy that we speak very lofty ideas and things, but when it comes to helping people, we actually lack. So I would like to see an India where this humanism is very, very important and where people help each other, like the way we experience this kind of thing in, say, Western countries, where human life, the value of human life is extremely high. If somebody gets injured in accident, probably sometime they will send air ambulance also to evacuate the person. Okay. So I wish I have a country like this where around two more than, I think, a lakh people do not die in road accidents. They are given help. I also think that we should be a country which actually should pride itself in love and on understanding rather than hatred. Hatred does not define any society, and hatred is never a lasting phenomenon. So I'll just recite a nazm of mine, and probably that will convey my message.
Please.
This nazm is Sarhad, border. Border is something which separates one from the other.
Mm-hmm.
So border sirf wo nahi hota jo geography mein hota hai. Border wo hota hai jo insaan ko insaan se alag karte hai.
Kya baat.
Wo mazhab bhi ho sakta hai, wo zaat bhi ho sakti hai, wo shakhs bhi ho sakta hai, wo zuban ho sakti hai, wo ilaqa ho sakta hai, wo culture ho sakta hai. Ab ye nazm suniye, Sarhad.
इर्शाद,
मिलने दो अब मिलने दो ना, मिलने दो अब मिलने दो ना, दिल से दिलों को जुड़ने दो ना, दिल से दिलों को जुड़ने दो ना, कलियां दिलों की खिलने दो ना, कलियां दिलों की खिलने दो ना, मिलने दो अब मिलने दो ना, दिल से दिलों को जुड़ने दो ना. एक सी रंगत एक सी बोली, एक सी रंगत एक सी बोली, एक ही मिट्टी एक सी बातें, एक ही मिट्टी एक सी बातें, एक सी खुशियां एक से दुख हैं, एक सी खुशियां एक से दुख हैं, एक से दिन हैं एक सी रातें, एक से दिन हैं एक सी रातें, ख्वाब भी हैं एक जैसे ही जब, ख्वाब भी हैं एक जैसे ही जब, रंग फिर उनमें भरने दो ना, रंग फिर उनमें भरने दो ना, मिलने दो अब मिलने दो ना, दिल से दिलों को जुड़ने दो ना. रिश्ता और नाता भी वही है, रिश्ता और नाता भी वही है, ख्वाहिश व ख्वाब दुआ भी वही है, रिश्ता और नाता भी वही है, ख्वाहिश व ख्वाब दुआ भी वही है, मायूसी आशा भी वही है, मायूसी आशा भी वही है, मिलने का जज्बा भी वही है, मिलने का जज्बा भी वही है, फूल और फल दरिया भी वही है, फूल और फल दरिया भी वही है, फिर ये बस पिघलने दो ना, फिर ये बस पिघलने दो ना, मिलने दो अब मिलने दो ना, दिल से दिलों को जुड़ने दो ना। हुस्नो इश्क भी एक से अपने, हुस्नो इश्क भी एक से अपने, एक सी हसरत एक है सपने, एक सी हसरत एक है सपने, खौफो यकीन भी साथ हमारे, खौफो यकीन भी साथ हमारे, हरसू वहशत पाँव पसारे, हरसू वहशत पाँव पसारे, सरहद हम दोनों को पुकारे, सरहद हम दोनों को पुकारे, हाथ पकड़कर चलने दो ना, हाथ पकड़कर चलने दो ना, मिलने दो अब मिलने दो ना, दिल से दिलों को जुड़ने दो ना।
बहुत ब्यूटीफुल सर, वी सिंसियरली एंड ऑनेस्टली बिलीव कि दिल से दिल को मिलने दो ना इज अ थॉट दैट विल वीव इंडिया एज वन नेशन, वन इंडिया, वन इंडियंस। आई सल्यूट यू फॉर दिस ब्यूटिफुल नज़्म दैट इज सिंपली मैग्नेटिक, मार्वलस एंड मेस्मराइजिंग। थैंक यू वेरी मच खालिद साहब, आपने अपना बहुमूल्य समय दिया, तहे दिल से शुक्राना। इट्स ब्यूटिफुल मोमेंट्स, अनफॉरगेटेबल, एंड वन ऑफ द ब्यूटिफुल पॉडकास्ट दैट हैज कम माई वे, एंड आई थैंक यू फॉर योर टाइम, ट्रस्ट, रिपोज। जो आपने सर आपने नज़म पढ़ी और जो आपने गजलें लिखी, आपने जो एंथोलॉजी और जो ह्यूमन सोसाइटी के लिए काम किया, उसके लिए व्यू पॉइंट की टीम और आवाज द वॉइस की ओर से हम आपको सलाम करते हैं सर। आपकी हर जज्बे को सलाम, आपकी हर जुनून को सलाम, आपके हर कलम को सलाम, आपकी हर जुबान को सलाम।
शुक्रिया, मेहरबानी, थैंक यू
सो मच।